type of women which is will appear the last days without, like what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam described them. They are not wearing the proper clothes, like what Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. No. This type of women, they will not smell the refreshness of paradise, which is mean they will be away, distance from it. And he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, إذا ظهر فيكم مثل ما ظهر في بني إسرائيل صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إذا كانت الفحشة في كباركم والعلم في أراذلكم والملك في صغاركم. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم, when they asked him, يا رسول الله, when we should stay home, we cannot make أمر بالمعروف, joining people for معروف or forbidding them for منكر. He said during that time when you see the oldest among you making فاحشة adultery, during that time just stay home. يعني اتركهم بقى, leave them alone, خلاص, you cannot do anything. If you see these old people, they are making adultery and fahisha. Old, somebody old must come to the masjid, not doing this, you know. And also, والعلم في أراذلكم, the one who's memorizing علم and knowledge and talking about Islam, that one which is, يعني, somebody is, he has nothing to do with that. يعني, this is not his job, you know, just can talk. And والملك في صغاركم, you see the youngest among you became king or president. So somebody has no value, just he know nothing, just because his family, his dad was from the royal family or from the kings, he became king because his dad was king. He cannot carry the responsibility. When you see this time, means the big crab, you cannot do nothing. This is what he said. He said also, people enter deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala groups, afwaja. ورأيت الناس يدخلون في دين الله أفواجا. People will go out from Islam also أفواجا, groups. Groups like that, subhanAllah. Like the same, likewise, the same, they enter groups in Islam, they will get out from Islam also groups like that. This is what Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, the time of fitan, that will happen also. And he said صلى الله عليه وسلم, وَيْلُ لِلْعَرَبْ مِنْ شَرٍ قَدْ اقْتَرَبْ. Woe to Arab, from that evil is coming soon to them. Nowadays, see what happened to the Arab people, like the tribes of Arab before Islam. They used to kill each other, attack each other, taking the women of each other. This was like this, the all Arab before Islam like that. You know, this tribe is stronger than that tribe. Oh, tomorrow we're gonna attack the tribe of Abs or the tribe of whatever. Yalla, let's go. Subhanallah. And you see, they go, they attack, they take their women, their sheep, their properties, everything. The same thing nowadays. Well, woe to Arab. From that evil is coming soon to them. What happened, Ya Rasulullah? He said, during the time, the man in the morning, mu'min, in the evening, kafir. He became kafir the same day. Why, Ya Rasulullah? His deen has no value on his side. He can just throw it like that. And he said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, during that time, the one who's really stucking with his deen, like the one who's carrying burning stone in his hand. كَالْقَبْدَ فِي يَدِهِ عَلَى جَمْرِ. This is what he said, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And he said, كيف بك يا ثوبان. ثوبان, the servant of Rasulullah. Rasulullah is telling him, what do you think, يا ثوبان, that day gonna come, all nations will be against you, against the Muslim Ummah. And he said that, يا رسول الله, يا أبي أنت وأمي, I sacrifice my parents for you, يا رسول الله, my dad and my mom. Why? Because we are few in number during the time. ثوبان was asking Rasulullah, I sacrifice my parents for you, يا رسول الله. During that time, we're going to be few of number. Wild nations going to be against us. This is the reason. And Rasulullah said, no. Said, la, bal, la, nay. You're going to be a lot. ولكن, just like the foam of the ocean, you have no value. You have no value. Somebody have no value, his enemy can attack him easily like that. Can belittle him, look at him like this. Yallah, emulate. Can do whatever he wants with him. Why? Because he's weak. He's weak. If you have value, you're strong, people, when they're gonna talk to you, they're gonna look at you like this. Ah, let me count. Oh, that person, be careful. You know, this is a way. People think like this way. Somebody belittle somebody, they can do whatever they want with it. This is, we know this. They said, yeah, Rasulullah, because we are few of number during the time. He said, no, you're a lot. But like the foam of the ocean. Yeah, like the foam of the ocean, you have no value. This is what Rasulullah said. What is the reason, Rasulullah? He said, because you're gonna be weak, because al-wahan. You can say in Arabic, al-wahn or al-wahan, both are right. الوهن means weakness, because of your weakness, because of your weakness. And they said, what's our weakness, يا رسول الله؟ He said, حب الدنيا وكرهية الموت. Loving this dunya, this world, whatever in it, and hating to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're not ready to meet Allah. You're كرهية الموت. You don't like to die. This is what رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said. Also, during the time of this fitna, I explained that hadith before, fitna, the one who's sleeping during the time of fitna, better than the one who's sitting. And the one who's sitting better than the one who's standing, and the one who's standing better than the one who's walking, and the one who's walking better than the one who's riding. The one who's riding better than the one who's juggling or running. And they said, قَتْلَاهَا كُلَّهَا فِي النَّارِ. Those who being killed during the time of fitna, all of them will be in hellfire. All of them. القاتل والمقتول. The killer and the one who's been killed. Both will be in hellfire. Rasulullah sallam said, see, that was so bad. Yeah. طيب. What you have to do, ya Rasulullah, will make it short. He said, أُكْفُفْ نَفْسَكْ وَيَدَكْ وَأَدْخِلْ دَارَكْ. He said, be away from all of them. All of these problems, this fitan, this fighting, these troubles. Get out of it, stay home. أدخل دارك, enter your house. It's better, enter house, enter your house. And they said, here, قلت يا رسول الله, أرأيت إن دخل رجل علي دار, what about if I enter my house? And a man came to attack me in my house. Look what he said. قال, فأقفل بيتك, then lock it good, lock your house good. Make sure he cannot enter. فأقفل بيتك. He said, ya Rasulullah, what about if he came or if he entered my house? He said, فَادْخُلْ مَسْجِدَكْ. He said, then go to your masjid. Go to your masjid, وَاسْنَعْ هَكَذَا. Make your hand like this, keep your hand away from him. Catch your hand like this, don't hurt him, don't touch him, don't attack him. Be the best of the two sons of Adam, the one who been killed. What did he say to his brother? لَإِنْ بَسَطْتَ إِلَيَّ يَدَكَ لِتَقْتُلَنِي مَا أَنَا بِبَسَطٍ يَدِيَ إِلَيْكَ لِأَقْتُلَكَ إِنِّي أُرِيدُ أَنْ تَبُوءَ بِإِثْمِ وَإِثْمِكَ فَتَكُونَ مَسْحَبَ النَّارِ. If you raise your hand to kill me, I will not raise my hand to kill you, because I want you to take my ithm, my sin, and to be in hellfire. The son of Adam, Habil, he told his brother when he tried to kill him, said, you kill me, I will not raise my hand to kill you. Why? Because you are the one who's going to be in hellfire. You're going to take the sin of this. That's why the scholar, they said, first person he invented killing in the earth, the son of Adam, Qabil, Cain. He is the first person he invented killing in the earth. Anybody will be killed until the day of judgment, Qabil will take share of this sin. Allahu Akbar, look how that. This is what his brother told him. Kill me, I will not raise my hand. Why? Because I want you to get the sin of this. لِتَبُوءَ بِإِثْمِي وَإِثْمِكَ فَتَكُونَ مِنْ أَصْحَابِ النَّارِ. Will be in hellfire. Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is telling the Sahabi here. He said, even if you come to your house, go to your masjid. If he raises his hand to kill you, catch your hand like this, strongly. فَقْبِدْ عَلَى يَدِكْ, كده, like this. Why? Let him kill you. Let him do whatever he wants. Don't touch him. Subhanallah. Like Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan. They came, Sayyidina Uthman, he understood. And the fitan started during the time of Sayyidina Uthman. Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan, before that, Kharbanin, they came to attack his house. Abdullah ibn Sabah and his group, they came from Iraq and they attacked his house while he was reciting Quran at night. What happened? The Sahaba, they came, Ya Uthman, let us fight, let us defend you. Sayyidina Uthman said, no. Even the slave tonight, slaves in his house, he's gonna keep his knife in his bucket, he will be free. Don't raise knife, don't do anything. Let them come and they'll kill me, I don't care. But I don't need any Muslims to fight each other. Also very fast, I said also, same meaning here, all this fitan, you have to be away from it as much as you can. قال يا أبا ذر إذا أرأيت إن أصاب الناس جوع لا تستطيع معه أن تقوم من فراشك إلى مسجد كيف تصنع؟ قال أصبر يا أبا ذر إن أصاب الناس موت شديد كيف تصنع؟ قلت يا رسول الله أصبر. He said, what about if the جوع hunger come to the people? What I have to do? He said, just go to your masjid and be patient. And be patient. And during the time of Fitan, that will be big poverty, especially 7 years before the coming of the false Messiah. Gonna be Siniyika Siniyusuf. Siniyika Siniyusuf, 7 years of poverty. in the earth, special water, we will gonna kill each other for water. You know, subhanAllah. More than 75% of the earth, water. And people will kill each other for water. There is no water. And the one who can handle the water, the false Messiah. Now you want, you need water, you need food, follow me. Believe in me, I am your God. First you're gonna say, I'm your prophet. Then people will be around him, I'm your God. And this is the worst fitna, the false Messiah. SubhanAllah, Abu Dharr said, Ya Rasulullah, what I have to do is just stay at your masjid and be patient. SubhanAllah. He said, what do you think, Abu Dharr, about people one day they're going to kill each other, they're going to shed blood? He said, what I have to do, Ya Rasulullah, I said, stay home and lock your house. Don't let anybody come to your house. Also, this last hadith, said people will worship الأوثان, the idols again, and gonna be fitnat al-ahlas. Fitnat al-ahlas, also that fitna gonna be the day of judgment. I think we are very, very close to it now. That hadith also, yes, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in this hadith also, if somebody wants to go to Jannah, فَلْتُدْرِكْهُ مَنِيَّتُهُ وَهُوَ يُؤْمِنْ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. He must die while he believes in Allah, the oneness of Allah, and the hereafter. And you have to wish for others whatever you wish for yourself. He said, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمْ أُمَّتِي تَهَابُ الظَّالِمْ أَنْ تَقُولْ لَهُ إِنَّكَ ظَالِمْ فَقَدْ تُوُدَّعَ مِنْهُمْ. If you see my ummah, they are afraid of the oppressor, and they cannot tell him, even you are oppressor. He said, forget them. And he said, before the day of judgment, my ummah gonna be khasf and maskh. Khasf and maskh, like big earthquakes. Big earthquakes. And he said, سَتَكُونُ فِتْنَةٌ سَمَّاءُ بَكْمَاءُ. That fitna gonna be like dumb. Fitna. Dumb. Very dumb. He said, مَنْ أَشْرَفَ لَهَا أَسْتَشْرَفَ لَهُ وَوَقَعَ اللِّسَانِ فِيهَا أَشَدُ مِنْ وَقَعَ السَّيْفِ. He said, keep your tongue, because the tongue during the time of fitna gonna be sharp like a sword. It's bitter, and you can cut somebody with your tongue. You can destroy him completely with your tongue. You can say anything about him. Imagine somebody, the imam, or somebody, the imam is leading your prayer, if they interest in him. Somebody in the community said, that sheikh is kharban, or that sheikh is doing so and so. See, and he's spreading that in the emails and whatever. Like a sword. People, they try to bury somebody alive. Yes. Why? Because he's trying to beat him down, he's trying to burn him, don't trust him anymore. See? This is the way. This is how people blame with others now. The sword, like the tongue, like a sword. He want to make destruction, he want to make corruption in the community. Why? By tongue, just strong words. And if the word comes out from your mouth, you cannot return it back. You cannot return it. That's why Rasulullah said. Also, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said during the time of fitna, Constantinia will be opened before Romania. Romania means Roman, Byzantines, the Roman now. You can say America and Europe. And said the Constantinia, what is in Turkey, it will be opened. It will be opened before this. Which is why? Turkey, they are not Muslims. No, somebody gonna attack Turkey. And Turkey will be ruled by non-Muslim people. Then, during that time, Muslims gonna open it again. Turkey now is, yeah, they were Almaniyin, secular at the Kharbanin. Now they are okay, I can say, but Allah knows what can happen tomorrow. We don't know. We don't know. The fitna is still around Turkey and around this area again. Yes, I will finish with this hadith. I don't want to make it long for you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman, he mentioned that, وَيَبْدَأُ الْخَرَابُ فِي أَطْرَافِ الْأَرْضِ حَتَّى تَخْرِبُ مِصْرُ. And the kharab, or the word kharab in the hadith, if I say somebody kharban, being corrupted, يعني. Kharban is not anymore, that's a haritha. وَيَبْدَأُ الْخَرَابُ. The kharab, corruption, gonna start in the borders of the earth, around the earth, يعني. And حَتَّى تَخْرِبُ مِصْر. And until the Egypt will be corrupted. Now almost, okay. وَمِصْرُ آمِنَهْ مِنَ الْخَرَابِ حَتَّى تَخْرُبُ الْبَصْرَةِ. Misr, Egypt, will be secured until the Iraq will be corrupted. And the Iraq already been corrupted. طيب. وخراب البصرة من الغرق. البصرة, البصرة means Iraq. They used to call during the time of Rasulullah, all the entire Iraq, they used to call it البصرة and الكوفة. Now they call it Iraq. اوكي عند البصره وخراب مصر من جفاف النيل. The corruption of Egypt because of the Nile River gonna be dry. There is no water. And this is what they are doing now. In Ethiopia, they are making dam. And now they are building it. And little by little, there is no water gonna be in Egypt. And the Basra, الغرق. People, الغرق, which means the lots of water. Opposite. وخراب مكة وخراب المدينة من الجوع. And مكة, and المدينة will be خراب also. Out of hunger. Hunger in Saudi Arabia? Yes, this is what he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وخراب اليمن من الجراد. You know, الجراد اللي هو locust. Locust, yeah. اليمن. وخراب الأبلة من الحصار. أو الأبلة من الحصار. أبلة اللي هي البصرة also. وخراب فارس برجن من الصعاليق. الصعاليق, the gangs people. Gonna be in Iran, فارس برجن. Gonna be خراب because of them. وخراب الترك من الديلم. والديلم من الأرمن. أرمن بي يعني ترك الأرمينيا. Yes, because they're gonna corrupt Turkey. Do you know why? Who knows? Because until now Armenian, when they see anybody Uthmani or Turkish, they have a lot of hatred against them. Do you know why? Because they claim the Uthmani during the empire of Uthmaniyin, they killed a lot of Armen. And this Arman, until now, say, the empire of Muslims, we hate Muslims. Why? Because Osmani, which is Turkey during the time of the empire of Osmani, they used to kill a lot, they killed a lot of Arman. That's why, until now, as I meet some of them here, they hate us because of this. They said, you're Turkish people, you've been corrupted people, you killed a lot of us, a lot of us. وخراب الأرمن من الخزري, وخراب الخزري من الترك, وخراب الترك من الصواعق, وخراب السندي من الهند. Who knows the Sind and who knows the Hind? In Hindu, we know India. But who knows the Sind? What's the Sind now?
Sind, part of Pakistan.
Part of Pakistan. Okay. And the Kharab, a Sind, that part of Pakistan because of Hind, because of Raza Qasim. Okay. Wakharabul Hind min al-Sayyid. Who gonna corrupt India? China. They say, this is what Rasulullah said. This is a hadith in Imam al-Qurtubi. The one who gonna corrupt India, Chinese. He said, India min al-Sayyid. وخراب الصين من الرمل. الرمل عدو النور الرمل صراحة تبي أنا زيديو. وخراب الحبشة من الرجفة. بيج أنت كوك جنبين أبوسينيا جنبين خراب الصدر. وخراب الزوراء من السفياني. الزوراء around the around مدينة السفياني. أبو سليمان you know سفيان right فتنة السفياني. You don't know أبو سليمان أنت. They have to take the citizenship away from me from Saudi. You don't know Sufyani? Sufyani, that man, he's claiming he's one of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's descendants, and he's not. That big corrupt man. He's gonna corrupt the Medina and around the Saudi, يعني around Mecca and Medina. وخراب الروحاء من الخسفي وخراب العراقي من القتلي. الروحاء, it's a place with, like 30 miles from Medina. That روحاء gonna be a big earthquake there. I think Allah أعلم that place when the army will look for المهدي. You know, it's called روحاء البيداء. Until now, don't tell me you don't know بيداء يا أبو سليمان. 30 miles from المدينة. That بيداء area, it's a very small sign like this. You can read it, بيداء. There is حديث مسلم said that big army will try to attack مكة. That army, the earth will swallow them completely. That hadith, authentic hadith.